Dearly beloved, we have gathered here today to celebrate the life and legacy of the late Sister Jacquess Jackie Gordon Jackson, very dear member of the Good Old Christian Baptist Church, full of love, full of light, beautiful lady, loving personality. She is the wife of Mr. George Getz, the mother of Mr. Gordon, and daughter Shaiza. Other members of the Gordon and Jackson family, we would implore you to look to the hill from which cometh our help. All of our help comes from the Lord. We are grateful to God that He has blessed us today with the presence of so many members of the clergy. At this time, you will see that God has blessed us in the way of personalities to carry His word. And this time, I want all the ministers to stand. All the ministers and pastors to stand. Thank you. We shall follow the order of service. Those first that are standing, you can now take some of those seats that were placed there for your comfort. When we sing again, we'll sing, "Oh, I Want to See Him," hymn 240. Scripture lessons, Old Testament, the Reverend Phil Watson. New Testament, the Reverend Laverne Bryan. Prayer, Reverend Dr. Norm Gamble. Solo, Miss Sharon Harris. Expressions from the church, we have Deacon Ronnie Sad. Scads, Dolores Hughes, President of the Williamsburg County Chapter. Department of Mental Health, Miss Martha Scott. Community, Mr. Jesse Park, Mayor of Greenville. From the family, you'll have to read his name. Rathmere Ball. Then we shall have the acknowledgement by the husband, Mr. George Jackson. After which, we'll have a selection by Mr. Stanley Montgomery. And then, the word of God. Amen. From the man of God, Pastor Dean D. Harris, pastor of the Body of Christ Church, Columbia, South Carolina, Recession. Let us follow the program as outlined.
Amen.
Thank you.
reading the Old Testament scripture, and I'll be coming from the book of Psalms. The 23rd Psalm is what I'll be reading into your hearing. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Praise the Lord, the word of God for the people of God.
Amen. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
I'll be reading from the New Testament scripture coming from the Gospel according to St. John. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in right. me. And my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you into myself, that where I am, that ye may be also. And whether I go, ye know, and the way ye know. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we know not whither thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, that I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man come unto the Father.
But I
something softer for me. Added to the necrology of the family, we'll have two of Jackie's best friends, Mr. Chase Blouse and Ms. Shonda Burgess. They are also called sisters to share after with Miriam Barr. Representing the family, they will come after that. George, permit me a 60-second spot. I've known Jackie for over 50 years. Your father, your mother, when Jackie was coming up, it was Jackie from Bethlehem and Keisha from Piney Grove. Hung together tightly. Jackie had the grace and the intellect and the style of her mother. Susie Gordon was some kind of stylish woman and a woman of much integrity, beauty, and charm. She got her boldness from her daddy. Those of you who knew the Reverend B.J. Gordon, who was my brother. And I knew her long before she was Jacquez. When she was at Benedict College, she was Jackie. When she left, she became Jacquez. Kind of like Jennifer Gambit. When she went to South Carolina State, she was Annie Bell. When she came back, she was Jennifer. George and Gordon and Shaisha, other family and friends have come to share in the celebration to our presiding officer, Dr. Walker, the eulogist, Dr. Harris, and all of the preachers and pastors. We've come to share with this family in such a time as this. So if you will, I know Philly Dixon's going to pray with me because I heard it from the time I got in here. If you have a preacher, pray anyway. The Billy's in the house. Amen. Hallelujah. God is good all the time. It's from an African proverb, respond to the call. Let us pray. God and our Father, we praise you. We honor you. We bless your name. It is you whom the Hebrews call Yahweh, Elohim, and Jehovah. In the book of Genesis, they call you El Shaddai, God Almighty. We've come now, Lord, to celebrate you. We've come to praise you, to lift your name up, because you're worthy. You're worthy to be praised. We've come with this family of George and Gordon and Zaija and other family friends to say that we've got you. But more importantly, God has you, because you are God who will take care of us in our despair, in our desperation, even in our anger and anguish, because sometimes as humans we raise the question, why Jackie? Why now? But Lord, we know that you know best. Yes. You told her from the time she was born that I have plans for you. Plans to rear you in the admonition of me, and plans to mature you and maturate you in the word. And Lord, we thank you for Jackie. Lord, we look on the program and we see her smile, and that's how we remember her. As a smiling saint, as a woman of God, as a mother, as a wife, we remember her sacrifice unto you. Because one day she said to Jesus Christ, Jesus the Christ, I yield. I can hold out no longer. I want Jesus to be my Savior and my Lord. So right now, Lord, in the name of Jesus, hold us in the palm of your hand. Rock us and shake us, and shake us and rock us. And remind us that earth has no sorrow, that heaven cannot heal. You told us with your word that we can neither do for a night. But joy, oh joy, joy, joy will come in the morning. So right now, Lord, help us to feel your joy. Help us to be reminded that we too must pass this way. That we will have eyes that will not see, ears that will not hear, heart that will not beat, brain that will not think, hands that will not clap, feet that will not walk. And we have to do exactly that the other day. Do some more of some things now. We've got to love each other more, support each other more, call each other more, visit each other more, take care of each other more, so that when our times are come to press a dying pillar, we can hear what Jackie heard from the other day. Well done. Then we all say amen. Somebody tell him thank you. Somebody tell him thank you. Somebody tell him.
She will receive her crown. head of my life, to our presiding officer, Reverend Dr. Luke Walker Jr., other participants of this homegoing celebration, to our eulogist of the hour, to my family, friends and neighbors who have gathered here on this Lord's Day. We count it a blessing to be in a position to celebrate the life of one we loved and still do.
Yeah.
George, I grew a little concerned about 2, maybe 3 minutes ago. There's a guy who started walking in this direction, and then he got on the choir trough. And I thought Glenn Kennedy was going to go solo on it. No word. I think we might be all right. So as I pondered what I would share, I realized what I and perhaps many others are experiencing. I read somewhere where it says these are the best of times and these are the worst of times. And so I thought about it and I satisfied myself that that is what I am experiencing at this hour. Wednesday was one of the more difficult days I've ever experienced in my life. I won't say why, but if you would just pray for me, then I've experienced one of the worst days of my life.
All right.
And so these are the best of times because I have so much to rejoice in. When I think of the memories of Jackie, how we got an opportunity to worship with her, to fellowship with her, and just to be one of her loves. When Jackie first said, "Hey, my love," I felt really, really special. Quite frankly, I was probably a little puffed up until I heard her call other people her love. Jackie's got love for everybody. Jackie lived a wonderful, beautiful life. She got the opportunity to love others and to be loved by others. And she had the radiant smile and the laughter. So we live, we love, we laugh, and then we transition. I want to reflect just for a moment on my last opportunity to kind of hang out with Jack West. It was a Saturday, so the Florida Gators were playing. We had had the SCADS event that morning. And so I walked into the hospital, Jennifer and I, and told Jackie that I had come to visit her and watch the Florida Gators play. And so she wasn't offended by the fact that I had come to watch the game. I mean, that's what we do. That's what George and Glenn and I do in her presence. And so that did not surprise her one bit. But what surprised me was she said no. Not until I told her about the SCADS walk. SCADS, y'all, is the organization that brings about awareness to sickle cell. And so we gather every year around or about this time, and we celebrate our sickle cell anemia warriors. We encourage them. We let them know that they are not alone in their struggles. And for those of us who are given positions of authority, we commit ourselves to bringing about the resources that we can to help the community. And so she said, no, not until you tell me about the SCADS event and how it went. And so I rejoiced in telling her how beautiful it was, how the Spirit of God was in that place. And how we decided on that day Representative Roger Kirby and I, that we would have a sickle cell anemia day at the Capitol, where we will bring sickle cell warriors, the health community, lawmakers, and everybody to Columbia to make absolutely certain that people know that when sickle cell anemia warriors go to the hospital, they're not drug addicts. They're not seeking drugs, they need help. So, after I shared that with Jack, she let me watch the game. One more point, because I promised myself that I would not be too long. Lord knows I love Jackie. I just cherish all our memories. I cherish them all, Jackie. We've had a great run with her. But I gotta say this. Things happen that we get an opportunity to witness. And I truly believe that we get a chance to witness it for a reason. And if we sit idle and do nothing, recognizing that there is something that has come our way, then that's on us. And so one of the things that became very apparent to me in Jackie's struggle was the need for us to give blood. And so I have committed, and I'm asking you all to do the same thing, I have committed to being a part of donating blood, being a part of putting on events where others get an opportunity to donate blood. It's cliche-ish, but the reality is, it is a life-saving measure. And too many of us are idle. Amen. Somebody starting with this one. But we've got an opportunity to help that community. And so we're going to organize in Jackie's memory. We're going to go to Columbia in Jackie and Nell and others' memory. And we will not allow their living to be in vain, because there's a legacy there. There's a legacy there that I want to be a part of for the rest of my life. And so we thank God for the undeserved opportunity to have the diva, Manny, that's right, the diva, in our lives. And I appreciate something that's happening here.
Yeah.
In spite of our sadness, there's somebody in here who wants to celebrate. In spite of our sadness, there's somebody who knows that the God we serve is too wise to make any mistakes, is too just to do it wrong. So I believe, ma'am, that the Lord is going to sustain us.
Yes.
I believe He will make us warriors for good. I believe He has empowered us in such a way that ain't no stopping us now. And so may God continue to bless our friend George, my nephew Gordon, I call him G, Shiaja, all the rest of this wonderful family. One more thing. Yeah, I know Jeff. I just enjoyed, and this is one of what I call the joys and pains of life, but I just enjoyed the trees and the shaman. Y'all, I just enjoyed y'all. I love your relationship with Jackie. I'm glad I've got friends like you all have. And the experience that I have with y'all, I'll just take with me for the rest of my life, because it's an experience of love. And that's all of us want to experience. That's what sustains us in life.
Yes.
It's the love that we have for each other. And so anyway, that's too much. All right, thank y'all. Guys.
On behalf of SCADS, I, Dolores Parson Hughey, greet you, pastors, ladies, and gentlemen, our warriors, and our dearly beloved Jackson family through the mercies of God. To the Jackson family, today, we desire to honor and remember the life of our warrior, Jackie. The chain is broken. When the reality of death sets in, we are often taken by shock. As we work through our hurt and our pain, we are remembering the positive difference that Jackie made in this world, and that Jackie made with SCADS. Thank you to Senator Sab for just telling our cause, talking about SCADS and what we're trying to do. Jackie, in her last text that she sent to our SCADS members, Samantha, Gwen, and Trina, Samantha said, "I love you all. I'm still fighting. I'm not going to stop fighting. We're not going to stop fighting for a cure, for her, for them, for us, all of our sickle cell warriors." Jackie sometimes would call me Lois, and she would say, "Lord, no, never Lord, let me get it right." She would say, "Lois, hello." I don't remember which one right now, because I'm just remembering so many other things about Jackie, but I do know one thing Jackie said. SCADS is my family. She said, "You guys are like my sister, but y'all are my family." And I appreciated that. And we were in the struggle together. So our tears, our memories, and emotion. We know that Jackie was not without pain, but we also know that Jackie touched many of our lives, many lives around South Carolina. Whether you knew Jackie as a wife, a mother, a co-worker, a friend, but we all benefited from Jackie's wisdom and our heartfelt advice. Jackie's advice to me and the nail passed along, and now I'm the president of SCADS, but that's just on paper. Jackie was always there as my advisor, pushing me forward. When I didn't understand something, I was like, "Jackie, where do we go next? What are we supposed to do?" Mm-hmm. You know? And Jackie would always say, "No, you got this." At the time, I didn't feel like I had it. But Jackie would smile and just encouraging words. She made me believe, you know what? I might have this. I can do this. But we didn't do it without Jackie. We so appreciate everything that Jackie did for SCADS. I think of so many poems that I wanted to talk about that depict Jackie, but I kind of narrowed down. But what I do say, we as SCADS, all of our SCADS members, please rise. We as SCADS, we rise up. We rise up. In spite of the aches and pains, Jackie rose up. She rose up for more research. Thank you. She rose up for more research, preventive measures, greater awareness, and advocacy out there. Jackie rose up for a better quality of life for all of our warriors. Jackie rose up to continue the fight with SCADS when we were fighting for the infusion center that's in our new hospital that we now have, right along with Senator Sam fighting with us. Jackie could not give up. There are many days that Jackie didn't feel like moving or dragging slow or whatever, but Jackie came right on along fighting. Holding her side or whatever. George brought out our last sickle cell for 2021. We knew Jackie was still well, but she came, she was there. So we rose up. Jackie rose up on September 28th to meet Nell on her birthday. Nell's birthday is on the 28th. Jackie rose up. Jackie is like an oak tree. Her roots are stretched in the earth. Jackie's love are those roots of that oak tree. She stands strong and her roots are deep. We might forget what Jackie says, but we'll never forget how Jackie made us feel. The broken chain. You left us peaceful memories, Your love is still our guide. It broke our hearts to lose you, for part of us went with you, Jackie. Because of you, Jackie, we are so much stronger. We'll never stop the fight. We Scads thank you for your love, your passion, your dedication, your wisdom, and your guidance. Our family chain is broken. But as God calls us one by one, that chain will link again. We miss you, Jackie. We love you, Jackie. We're going to keep celebrating with Jackie. We have scholarships in honor of Jackie. We're going to partner up right with Senator Sam, and we're going to do blood drives. We will still be around, all in honor of Jackie. Quickly, I want to end with that as I broke the chain. I was driving in. I saw the Jeep look like Jackie. I felt like Jackie was riding with me. One thing about Nell and Jackie, they were always at school, they were at the parades, they were just dancing, all kinds of stuff. You were at the parade, Jackie and Nell were probably the last entrant, pulling up the rear, trying to put the banner stuff on the thing. Trying to put the banner on whatever vehicle they were entering. But they were gonna make it. And I was laughing to myself as I thought that Jackie's passionate. And I felt this win. And I said, Jackie, I got it. I got it. I finally got it. It's not the Swift, but they showed up. They might have not been there at the beginning.
Come on.
But they showed up and they supported us and they fought for Scads. I thank you for your time. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God.
Each time we say Jackie, I always have to go back and say Bernell. And then I have to say Samantha. I guess she was the youngest sister to them whom this dreadful disease is not supposed to let you get. But so many years of God's grace, but by the grace of God and through Jesus, they have gone far beyond that. As we all transition, we sing and tell Jack, where's Jackie? We tell these stories for months, and we'll never get it all done because she was that important to everyone. She was that good of a spirit, a good heart. Everyone who serves was not necessarily called, but in her case, she was God's angel on earth to lead in a disease. And the words I have here is from the little sister, now that we don't have Bernell, now that we don't have Jackie, but I'm going to say this on behalf of Samantha, because Ruth's given, but she was also the lady who lived at the house by the side of the road. The one that you came for advice and wisdom and you would never turn away. She was going to show you love, the same love that you felt was special to you, but then now we know through the senator and everyone else that this is her feeling to everyone. But she was a golden type of love. She was a friend to all. She was a warrior. And today, we're having the warriors dance across heaven as she spreads her sparkle to them. Right now, she probably should be leading the choir, and she might look back and tell somebody that they're all key. But we just want to thank her for her genuineness, because as she saw it, it's how you were going to get it. That was the beauty of her, a beauty among many. So I want to thank each and every one of you for letting me stand on behalf of Samantha. And we're going to ask that she so ever be safe to serve in God's arms, and knowing that today, heaven has gained. George and the rest of the family, please accept my small platitudes of gratitude to you. Thank you.
On behalf of the Department of Mental Health, it's just so much that we can say about the Gordons and Jackie. But I know we have time limits here today. And when I put my thoughts together as I was sitting, partner. We all look for partners. But the garden trained Jackie and myself as a younger to be godly partners. God set a vision years ago with Reverend B.J. Gordon.
Come on now.
To open what we know now as disability and special needs. But then he had a new name. It was Gordon Developmental Center.
Yeah, come on now.
That served many, many folks that had disabilities to help the families in the community.
Well, yeah.
He trained us to step into this arena with love and compassion. And I had the opportunity as a young girl to work and help train Jackie. Jackie is such a loving, loving, kind, sweet person. And on top of that, she was pretty. We had many rides up and down the road to go and get some of the folks that they had institutionalized on Bull Street. We could hear the doors slamming behind us. I could recall Williamsburg Residential Care. They're known across the state of South Carolina as the home that takes the worst of the worst of mental illness. I said godly partner. Jackie became a trustful partner. Because I'm the one that would travel up and down the state facilities, the mental health institutions, and I would call her back. I would describe folks that I screened in hopes that they could give them an opportunity to come to their home. She never said no. Some of the folks came that were receiving what we call pancake dinners. Now, pancake dinners is where they are so institutionalized that they're eating with their hands, and they're not standing. They're sitting beside a wall with an institutional stoop. Jackie would say, yeah, bring them. They were getting pancake dinners because they couldn't open the door for these folks. These folks had their food slid under the door, and I would scream them and say, yeah, I believe we can bring you back to the community, bring you back home. With Reverend Gordon and Miss Gordon training Jackie, they released the fear of loving people, even at their worst. Many of those folks lived at Williamsburg Residential Care. They moved from there with great nurturing and love. They move into what we call home share. The Gardens participated in that. They took them into their home, cared for them in their personal home. And now, some of those residents that they are still loving and caring for live in their own apartments after 28 years in the institution.
Sit down, serve up.
George, I just looked at Glenn when I walked up and I asked him what he's looking at me for. That's the only reason I asked him that. But anyway, let me say that I met Jackie years ago. Sam was talking about his family, and that's his family, and all that. But Jackie was a part of another family that resided here in Greenville. And that was, I got two of them back here on the stand now on the choir loft. I don't know why they're back there. Glenn and Cuddy and George, and I don't see any more, but there was a team that played baseball for years in this area. One was called the Sluggers and the other one was called the Tucks. And we had a merger here back and everybody became a Tuck, and Jackie was a part of that family also, that baseball family that we had here in Greenville. And later on I learned something about Jackie. Me and Dale, as you all heard the name mentioned earlier, we raised up, went through school like brothers and sisters. That's the kind of relationship Dale and myself had. And later on, I learned that Jackie and Vernell shared the same disease. And this is something that I was a part of as we came through school. Some days we would, everybody out having fun, and then the next thing we knew, when Nell left, she ended up in the hospital for the next 2 or 3 days. And so I grew up with knowing a little bit about sickle cell syndrome because of Nell. And back when they decided to do this SCAD walk here in Greenville some 6-7 years ago, they were looking for some place to do that. And Nell came to me, Dolores, Jackie was a part of it. And simply because of my relationship with Nell and Jackie, you know, I told them, yeah, I'm for it. Whatever Nell wants, you know, Jesse is with it. And Jackie was a part of that also. And they've used the Kennedy Center here in Greenville probably for the last 7 years or better than this. This is a rental center that we use, but the SCAD organization has never paid a dime to use that center. And as long as they want to have that walk here in Greenville for the SCAD, they will be doing so. Something came up here with the walk this year. I know I got a call from Dolores, a couple members of her family, several members of the SCADs. It was coming right up to the event that weekend. And for whatever reason, they were under the impression they could not have it here in Greenville this year. And so, you know, like I said, from some of the conversation I got, you know, I just told Dolores, and I remember James. You know, last time I looked, I was the mayor of the town of Greenville. And y'all know the planning. And whatever it is you want to do, it's done. I'll call my chief and he's going to make the arrangements, the roads, all this and all that. You all continue with your plan. And that's the way it's going to be as long as I'm here in Greenville anyway. But let me just say too, when George called me a couple of days ago about making some remarks from the community about Jackie, I remember what someone told me years ago about, you know, every now and then trying to find a word to define yourself. And I do that from time to time. It's not easy trying to find a word to define yourself. And so I was trying to figure out, okay, these kids, all these younger kids in here, you know, they got this weird, these phones, they text, they do all that, they do it in a fast manner. So my phone, well, I just don't know how to use it in that manner. But George called it the same way. You over there smiling. I know Ronnie is sad. He can't do it either. But anyway, I got an app downloaded to my phone. And I talked to my phone. And I asked questions, the same thing you type in, I got to ask my phone. So I put in a couple of comments, and I'm about to get into that, about Jackie, trying to find a new word to describe Jackie. And when I put this information, I got through talking to my phone, as they say, there was this word that popped up. And it said, virtuous. So I went on and got the definition of virtuous. And it says, in the Bible, Proverbs, I need some water, 31 defines a virtuous woman as a woman who leaves her home with integrity and discipline and more. All the virtues she practices are aimed at making her husband's life better, teaching her children, and serving God. This essentially is the meaning of a virtuous woman. And let me just say this, and one of the reasons I said this about Jackie, since I became mayor of Greenville, every time me and Jackie meet, Jackie would always ask me, how was my mayor doing? She didn't live here in the town of Greenville. George, you know this, but every time me and Jackie got together, it's, how is my mayor doing? And you know, that just gave me a good feeling. There's nobody in this town really that voted for me ever asked me that type of question. You know, there's always somebody complaining about something. George, you know, I can't ever pronounce her name, so I'm not going to try. She knows who I'm talking about. Anything I can do for you guys, you know all you got to do is just let me know. Thank you.
Childhood as But she wasn't just that to me. I know she has touched countless of lives of friends and family who are here today. Jackie was one of the most outgoing people that I know. She unknowingly made me strive just a little harder to befriend others. Believe it or not, it's a struggle for some of us, but to her, it was just part of her natural charisma. That smile that reached her eyes, letting you know she was genuinely happy to see you. And it didn't matter whether or not it was yesterday or last year. The feeling of love you always received from her, the feeling was always love. As we became older and our lives shifted, and she still remained that person till that day. Marrying George, where I had to hear for the next 10 years, my husband. My husband this, and my husband that. Finally, I asked her one day, I think my girlfriend was with, well, does he have a name? His name is George. Would you please call him George? Because I was feeling a little jealous. Jackie didn't, it was just, we knew that all of these things were her, these things and having Gordon were part of the best decisions of her life. Jackie has never said, one more thing, even her fussing wasn't fussing. I don't know what that was she would do and tell you, but it never sounded like she was really fussing at you because she was just filled with so much love. So her fussing didn't even come over as her being angry or upset with you. I believe that her philosophy in life, even though she never said, I am not going to let Sickle Cell steal my joy. And you will not either. Cousin was a fighter. Just asked her husband, her son, and her daughter. She loved strong and fought even stronger. She loved and lived life hard, never letting it slow her down. Her sickle cell being her enemy, and she being the heroine of her life. In these past years, my cousin Gordon started the cousin reunion for our grandparents' grandchildren. We were now rebuilding our family bond. Jackie birthing our favorite word, cousin. So many times you will not even hear us address each other by our first name. We just go, hey cousin, how are you doing cousin? And she would say it the best of all. But now, we have this part of our lives to work with. We're now down to when the cousins got together, we had Mel, Fonza, Bernice, Benny, Joanna, Gwen. We would all sit there laughing and talking about our parents and their relationships. But now we will be speaking for our cousin. We will be your voice as we continue to sit around and pay homage to those who have gone before us. We will speak of our love for each other, our childhood, our parents' jokes, accomplishments, and lessons passed down. How you fought in the trenches of life with a smile on your face. Jack West took the good and the bad of life and created Jackie, a fighter, a wife, a mother, a soon-to-be grandmother, a perfect cousin, a loving niece, and a loyal friend. Each of us will leave this world with an accomplishment. Jackie was blessed to have accomplished so much in her life. However, we should remember she left two very large footsteps for us to fill. One being love and positivity. Keep a smile on your face, like her, through the pain. Second, fight. Fight for happiness, for life. We love you, Jackie, and we'll miss you, but we will see you again. Strong, healthier, and greeting us with that beautiful smile. My hashtag for today is love strong for JJ. And fight like Jackie.
Love you. Trees loves you. will forever, like she said, ice in case of an emergency. That's all y'all listed in my phone. I never thought it would be an emergency on September 28th. And as I traveled that road, I kept saying she was going to be there when I got there. Miss you, my girl. I am going to miss you. But she's promised she's going to take good care of me. She promised. And I promise the same. We love you.
Church, say amen.
Amen.
Something a little different today. I want you to feel it from my heart. The cards and the letters are all wonderful and fine texts, and we really appreciate it. But I want to say to the staff, thank you.
Amen.
For allowing me to take care of my wife for a month and a half in the hospital. And she knew her baby was well taken care of. So those are her babies.
Yes.
So to all the sisters, there's only two sisters listed on this program. But my wife has many sisters. And if she call you her sister, you better believe you her sister. I want to share just a little bit about her last few days in the hospital. On that Monday before she passed, doctor came in the room. We were sitting up on the suicidal side of the bed. We were talking. The doctor came in the room and said, how you feel? She said, I feel fine. She said, well, it's amazing you got a 4.3 hemoglobin and you sitting up on the side of the bed. My wife just said, just laughed at me. But anytime, if you know my wife, she laughed at you, that's mean God's in control of this, right? He's in control of this, right? So on the Tuesday evening, her hematology came in the room and her hemoglobin had dropped down to about, I think, 4.2, something like that. And he was sitting in the bed. And he was rubbing her on the leg. I looked at him. What am I doing? is a very, very good friend.
Church is out to answer to your name. You've got to answer to your name. When I call, you've got to answer.
Thank you.
here to celebrate. Sister Jaquest, Jackie. Amen. Gordon Jackson. Amen. God be the glory, rather than the name of Paul. Known her for most of her life.
All right.
Yeah, her daddy Lyson. Y'all the last minister he Lyson to preach the good news of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. I knew both her mother and father real well.
Yeah.
Amen. And he shared some good things. And he put some good things in me. And he put some good things in her. And all that had contact. Amen. And she got a lot of what she got from her mother and father. Amen. They went about doing good. They went about helping them. She's got a great, wonderful husband, son, and daughter. Amen. Chaiza, amen. Gordon, amen. And George. They talk about Chaiza. Gordon always been a fighter. Amen. Baseball. Her daddy taught him that baseball. We used to call him Master Gordon. He grown now. When he was young, we used to call him Master Gordon. When we was at a church, I used to pastor. My home church, a tiny little missionary Baptist church where she was a member. She also served as a secretary for a while at the church. Amen. To God be the glory. Amen. And Pastor Tony Grove now is Pastor Cannon. To God be the glory. And so, Shia, when you get that bar degree, you know, lift it up. I said, I got it. Amen. She's wrapping up law school. Amen. Amen. To God be the glory. Amen. We're going to go ahead because time is, I'm only going to be here for about 2 hours and then we're going to. Amen. To God be the glory. Don't look at me. Don't look at me sideways now. Amen. Amen. To God be the glory. Thank God for all that have been said and done. Amen. Brother George, you hung in there, brother. Amen. You've done your part. For better, for worse, for richer, for more sick, you did it all. Amen. You did it all. So don't let nobody. Amen. Amen. Yeah. You did what you're supposed to do. To God be the glory. Gordon, you did what you're supposed to do. Your mama loved y'all. Amen. She was willing to lay down her life. Amen. To help each and everybody that came in contact with her. She was a caring and sharing person. If you have your Bibles, we ask that you return to 1 Corinthians. Chapter number is 9. Thank God for the pastor of the church, Pastor Walk, and all these fellows suffer a little bit of gospel news, right? Thank you for allowing us to come and share with the family. We appreciate it and thank the family for allowing us to bring the words of comfort. Again, in 1 Corinthians chapter 9, beginning in verse number 24, we're reading from the New King James Version of the Bible, so we have a different translation. It's going to read slightly different. Just now, we're going to read from God's holy word. Do you not know that those who run in a race all run, but one receives the prize? Run in such a way that you may obtain it. And everyone who competes for the prize is temperate in all things. Not they do it to obtain a perishable crown, but we for an imperishable crown. Therefore, I run thus, not with uncertainty. I fight. Not as one beating the air, but I discipline my body and bring it into subjection, lest when I have preached to others, I myself should become disqualified. I want to preach for a little while from the subject. I've got mine. Don't you give up until you get yours. Somebody said, if you got Jesus, I got mine. Don't you give up until you get yours. Father, we thank you now for this preaching moment, God. Use me now as a tool, as an instrument in your all-wise, mighty, majestic, marvelous, magnificent hand. I yield to your God and say, not my will, but your will be done. Give us words now that will speak comfort, that will speak hope, that will speak direction, that will speak care. In the name of Jesus Christ, we do pray. We thank you for this family. Continue to strengthen them. Continue to bless them. We thank you for everyone under the sound of our voice, God. Continue to pour on us. Pray to heaven, feed us now until we want no more. In Jesus' name, and the people of God said, amen.
Amen.
Yeah. I've got it. I can hear it say, I've got it. That crown, not the one that's going to perish, but that imperishable crown. That's that for us in the Greek. That's that for us. That crown. Yeah. Everybody want the crown, but everybody don't do what's necessary to get the crown. And we, Bible said, we got in Hebrews, it said, therefore we must lay aside everywhere.
and a sin that was so easily beset up, and let us run. This way, living to who? Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. When we look at this passage of scripture in Corinthians, we see how Paul is instructing, and Paul is trying to encourage us, and he's making a comparison as being a believer, as being a Christian. I'm kind of questioning about what I call Christian. But everybody who calls themselves Christian ain't Christian. People get up and talk about, I'm a Christian, and they go to cussing and fussing a few words later. But Paul wanted the believers to understand in this Christian journey, it's a fight.
Yeah.
It's like being an athlete. And those of you who run track, you know about what it takes. You have to endure hardness, like Paul told Timothy. As a good soldier, you have to be disciplined. You have to be committed. You have to be dedicated. And we heard a lot of this about Sister Jackson, all right? About Jackie, all right? She was committed. She was dedicated. And she fought. Mm-hmm. When you run a track, and it also talks about being a boxer. I'm going to deal with that in a second. When you run a track, when you go into the track, you already know how the track is laid out. You know where the lines are. You know where the start point is, and you know where the finish. I hope I had a witness in there. And see, as believers in the Lord Jesus Christ, you must be born again in order to enter the kingdom of heaven, in order to get to the finish line, in order to get that crown of righteousness. Y'all ain't gonna talk back to me in here. They're just coming to the building, they gonna save you. You got to let your what's in you show up on the outside. Let your light so shine before men, women, boys, and girls, that they will see the good work. We heard about the good work. We heard about the servant. We heard about the sacrifice. May the work I do speak for me. May the life I live speak for me. May the service I bring speak for me. Paul said, run. Run it in such a way, knowing what you got in store, knowing what you're going to receive. Don't do like the people in the world. They're running for a perishable crown. See, you're running trying to see how many people like you. You're running trying to see how many people go friend you. No. You keep your eyes on him. And whether they friend you or not, man, you keep on pressing toward them all. Don't you give up until you get yours. There's two places, two stories, upstairs, downstairs, where you're going to be. Upstairs is heaven. You know what downstairs is. He said, you got to run towards heaven. Run on this journey, running this race set before us. Looking what? To Jesus. Who is what? The Alpha and the finisher of our faith. He said, don't you know we all run? But only one get the prize. See, now don't misunderstand it. We all ain't running against each other. No. I ain't running against you, and you ain't running against me. We running against the wild of the enemy. Paul said, we're wrestling up. You are running against the devil. We running our own race, and we running against the things of the world. We running against the things that's trying to hinder us, to keep us from getting into the glory, from keeping us from receiving our crown, from keeping us receiving that crown of righteousness. So a lot of times people want to compete. I ain't your competition. I ain't your problem. We got to love you one another as I have loved you, Jesus. Jesus, I come that you might have life. Have it more abundantly. You got to sacrifice. And she was willing to sacrifice. She even knew the struggle. Some of us, we got good health. And we won't take time to help nobody. And I ain't talking about people we don't know. I'm talking about people we do know. We won't take the time to share that love. We won't take the time to share that kindness. We won't take the time to share that generosity. I hope I had a witness in here. Many of us got family members and we want to come and we'll come to funerals and we'll come to this and that and other. But do you take the time to tell them you love them? Do you take the time to tell them that you care? Do you take the time to say, if you need me, I'll be there and mean it. See, you know who your friends are. I tell people, when you get sick, you know who your friends are. You'll see who show up. You see who really care. And you'll give the excuse makers. When they say, oh, God, you was on my mind. The devil is a liar. The devil is a liar. We came to bring the truth. My former pastor, Reverend B.J. Garden, brought the truth. And the truth is what makes us free. Winning the race requires determination, requires commitment, requires hard work. It requires discipline. Yes. With the pandemic going on, a lot of people have fallen by the wayside. A lot of people have gotten caught up on this perishable crown. They're trying to do the thing that pleases the world. But I want to encourage the believer, hold on to God's unchanging hand. He said he will never leave us, not what he would say. See, don't you know that you don't have to be in the building? Don't you know your body? It's a temple for the Holy Ghost. We come here to worship. We come here to encourage each other. We come here to assemble, to give a praise. But God ain't coming back to this. He's coming back to the believer. He's coming back to those who are sold out to the kingdom of God. That's why Paul said, I want to have you be ignorant. Bob said, I will not have you be ignorant concerning them. Never sleep. Sing God. He's coming back. I won't have you to be ignorant. Cheating here. Be absent in the body. Be present with the Lord. Yeah, Jesus in the judgment seat said, when I was hungry, you fed me. When I was thirsty, you gave me a drink. When I needed some clothes, you called me. When I was in sickness, you came and you visited me. When I was in prison, you checked on me. They said, Lord, when did we do this? When did she do it? And as much as you've done it to the least of these, my brother. My sister, you have done it unto me. Run in such a way, Paul said. Knowing he said, when you run, you know where you're going. People say, well, how do I know where I'm going? This is the real man. The word is a lamp unto my feet. The word is a lamp unto my back. The word I have hid in my heart that I may not sin against God. This joy I have. That's why when adversity came, when you were dealing with this, this joy I have. The world didn't give it, and the world can't take it away. She said, nothing but the blood. That's not the blood. Nothing but the blood. That's power. In that blood, one, the working power. Saving power. Delivering power.
In the blood.
In the blood. Don't you know, when this earthly house of the tabernacle is off, we have a bit. Now, me, Abraham, she knew what the word said, because her father. She had the word that seed was planted in her at an early age. And then when her mother and father passed on, they gave her the facility. And what was already put in her, when the person talked about how they were trained, they began to exhibit it. Now, Gordon, you got to continue. Amen. You got to continue that legacy. You got to continue to carry on as the Lord leads you. And as the Lord guides you, don't you know? We all going to have to pass this way. And she's got hers. And she would say to you, I want you to do everything you can to get yours. Because she was an encourager. She wasn't the person that when they get it, it's all about me, myself, and I. You know how some of us are. We get something and we want nobody else to have it. It could be something going on sale. It could be something happening down the street. It's something called, to, hey, the gas is only. Hey, this is going on. People line up for Black Friday, this, that, and other, trying to get stuff. Some say, hey, it's a deal. I know you were looking for this. We want to be the one. So everybody can look at us. I just told you we're not in competition with each other. And see, when you are truly a true believer of the Lord Jesus, you understand we're fighting the same enemy. The thief came to kill, to steal, and destroy. But Jesus, I'll come. That you might have life and have it more abundantly. I come that you might have life. I've never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. But I've done good and faithful. Serving for you have been faithful over a few things. Come on up. I'm going to make you ruler. A minute. He said, now, Paul said, now when you fight, he said, I know how to fight. He said, when I fight, I'm real calculated. I know how to swing it. I know how to uppercut it. I know I ain't just swinging beating the air. Because I understand beating the air gonna waste my energy. I'm tuning in where I need to hit. I'm tuning in where I need to punch. I'm tuning in where I need to run. I'm tuning in where I need to stand. good fight of faith. She fought. A good fight. See, it's easy for a person who ain't going through nothing. See, it's easy for us when you're not sick and you're not dealing with illness in your body. It's easy for us to go in the hospital and tell them, you're going to be alright, don't give up.
Yeah, yeah.
But when you've been fighting your whole life, when the odds were against you and you overcame that, tell them somebody, when you're fighting and when you know who your father is, when you get tired of fighting, you know that, you can say, Daddy, I'm ready. I'm ready. I'm ready to come on. And just like any good father, he's going to come and take care of the children. He's going to. See, that's the point I'm here. She didn't give up. She just transitioned. She went from life to life. See, death is just a through way. I'm about to wrap it up. Death is just a through way. It reminded me of this old lady who used to ride the bus. And then every day she would get off in front of the cemetery. She would ring the bell and she would get off and the people on the bus just looking at her. All side, why is this old lady going through the graveyard? Why is she getting off at the cemetery? And so one day one of the persons riding on the bus said, why you keep dropping off her here, off here? He said, look beyond the trees. Look at that tree. You see that white house that's sitting on the hill, and I'm for her to get home, she got to go through. The cemetery is appointed for us. We got to go. And I see come back before we go. And I want you to know that we must continue to fight the good fight. I should wear a crown. Yeah, yeah. Are you going to get yours? Are you going to succumb to the things of the world? Are you going to get yours? Are you going to let people talk you out? You going to that church, you worship God? That's old school. That's that time of life. You need to be you. You need to enjoy your life. See, you really need to. I'm enjoying my life. Being saved, being born again, it's free. It's what I'm stuck. Yeah, I can go to sleep at night and don't have to worry about whether I wake up or not because the living Christ and the dying is dead. And that's why Paul said, I'm ready to be offered up. You know. us up. Treat them important to them. And now we're trying to figure out what to do, Lord. The word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against God. She took a flight to the other side. Have you ever taken a flight? It's people that take you to the airport. McCall in Florence was the airport that she took her flight. And see, the family, when she passed from earth to glory, was waiting. Yeah. Might have been asked a question, why God? And people said, well, he didn't want to question God. Jesus questioned. He said, my God. My God, why have thou forsaken me? You got to read the book. And she got on the flight. Before they had all the security, you could go to the gate, you could watch the plane taxiing down the runway. And then you see the plane take off and disappear in the sky. And you say, oh, they're gone now. But what you feel and realize on the other side, when the plane cracked the sky covered, there's some people waiting. There's some people waiting on the other side. The Bible says, don't we have a great cloud of witnesses? And if your mother, your father, your grandmother, your granddaddy live right, they over there say, come over here with a table is spread. The feast of the Lord is going on. Every day will be like Sunday. And the Sabbath will have no end. And I can walk around heaven all day. For this corruptible must put on incorruption. This mortal must put on immortality. Then death is swallowed up in victory or death. Where is your strength? No grave. Where is your victory? For the strength of death is sin. And the strength of sin is what? Is the Lord. But thanks be to God who give us the victory through Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brothers and sisters, be steadfast. Don't give up. Unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much, know that your labor in Him does not in vain in Christ Jesus.
Thank you. was all